cooperate, girl. There we go.
Yes.
Thank you. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Substrate, moss, catch cup, tong, just a random container for God knows what. So yeah, we'll deal with that later, as well as a moldy enclosure. Yep, you heard me right, a moldy enclosure. I'm not gonna be swearing here because you guys know how much I hate moldy enclosures, but I'm just gonna keep myself cool for this video. Yeah. Actually no, because I just went to New Zealand. I just got back from New Zealand actually. I just went for a 2-week vacation, 2 weeks. And when I came back, I come back to freaking mold, because the thing is, I had this tarantula rehoused in here like 2 months ago. Yeah, 2 to 3 months ago. It was perfectly fine. It was super clean, mold free until I went to New Zealand. And then I came back from New Zealand. I just went for 2 weeks, guys, 2 weeks. And look at this. Yeah, not very happy about this. And just, that's just freaking nasty, man. I just hate this. So yeah, what we're gonna be doing today is, you guys probably already know, we're gonna be rehousing this tarantula. No, not into here. We're gonna be just rehousing her back into her current enclosure. But we're gonna be cleaning this thing out first, because let's do this. We've got tongs here. You see, I've got all the things prepared here, especially a catch cup, because this girl, this is my heart butt tarantula. For those who don't know, there's videos, like link in the description, about this tarantula. Quite a few of you guys have been asking me to see this girl again. So yeah, this is your lucky day. Not my lucky day because freaking mold, but your lucky day because you guys get to see this girl again. Now let's take out the water dish first, which is just pretty much a bottle cap, because this girl is pretty small. So we'll put this down here. Man, the glare. And check out the mold. Look at all these pieces of Yeah, so the thing is, this is a new world and she is bolty as heck. Yeah, you do not want to mess with a heart butt tarantula without a catch, oh my god, without a catch cup. So yeah, this thing right here, this thing is going to be our savior today in case this girl decides to bolt, because if she bolts, she's gonna go under Bella's enclosure. She's gonna go, like, could possibly go under the carpet, not sure, but she could possibly get under this sofa, which is pretty much the end, because when she goes under this, I mean, if she goes under, I'm not gonna be saying when, because if she goes under that, that is the end. There's so many places literally to hide. She can even go into, yep. So basically, she has made an entrance over here, as well as an entrance over here, or basically an exit there, or it's up to you. Whatever you want to think of it. So we're going to be getting her out. So hopefully she cooperates with us. Not sure where she is. Yeah, she's not there. So what I'm going to be doing is, oh, whoa, I never knew that. She actually made a burrow under the moss, which is pretty darn cool. All I thought was she made an entrance over here and an entrance or an exit, yeah. And then she lived under this moss, like over there. You see, it's like an umbrella, right? Thought she was just living like in that web. Like, you know, tarantulas, they make tunnels. But no, apparently she made a tunnel inside there for her retreat. You can look at her heart butt right there. It's like super fat and super healthy. So yeah, I hope this makes it easier, because I can just, yeah. I thought, just when I thought I was super prepared for this, no, I took a catch cup which doesn't even fit into the enclosure. Perfect. So the only way I'm gonna get her out is to pretty much to let her bolt. Genius. You guys ready to see her bolt? Come on, girl, do not bolt. You just walk slowly. Okay. Oh my god. Yep, you see, these new worlds, some of them can be pretty darn crazy at times. So I don't want to squish you, so you gotta like, oh, you see, why would you go back in there? I want you to get out so I can catch cup you. Like, oh my god, this is so frustrating, man. Get up. Oh yes, oh my god. No, I thought she would cooperate and just go in there and just, I have nothing to do. But no, apparently not. She just wants to, there we go, safe and sound. So now we're gonna mess with this. I'm done. So this empty random container will be the place where it's gonna hold all this junk. So yeah, there we go. Basically what I'm gonna be doing now is to get this washed and then put the substrate as well as, call this moss, back into this and her back into this, which is going to be, I don't know, we'll see how it goes later. So let's go give this a quick wash and we'll be back. Okay, and just like that, we've got a pretty clean enclosure. So what we're gonna be doing now is, first of all, you guys know my rehousing, like, steps. Yeah, so first of all, we're gonna be doing is putting the beautiful substrate. Just look at this, guys. Doesn't this thing like make you guys wanna like, no, okay. Let's just put this into here and stop being inappropriate, shall we? Yeah, I'm gonna be putting this into stop being blurry. Phone, stop being blurry. There we go. Yep, so I'm gonna be putting, just come on, man. Is this already moldy? Now you wanna screw with me over? Okay, so we're gonna be putting this in here like this so we don't make a mess, because you guys know I'm a pretty darn messy person. So now we're going to get substrate into this place over here. Yep, this is going to be taking a while because we get with one hand, but I mean, it's gonna work, right? It's gonna work. So one hand does, oh, see, thank goodness I put it into this random container over here, because if I had it on the carpet, it's gonna be like dropping all over the place, which is not ideal, because if I mess this carpet up with substrate, I'm gonna have to vacuum it, and I don't enjoy vacuuming. You see? Yeah, that's what I mean. Think that's enough substrate? Yep, looks good. Looks good. I don't know, depends. See how much it stays when I pack it down. Yeah, I think we're gonna be needing a little bit more. Just gonna be filling it up till, I don't know, close to the ventilation holes. So just a little bit. You see, this is what I mean. I'm super prepared. Just nice enclosure. I mean, not enclosure. Just nice amount of substrate. And we're almost done. So bear with me, guys. Bear with me, okay? Because this is my first video after returning back from New Zealand. So yeah, there we go. I think that's good enough. I'm not gonna be packing it down too hard because, I mean, under is already packed down. But the top should be, I mean, I wouldn't mind a little bit fluffy. I'm pretty sure the tarantula wouldn't mind as well. So yeah, I'm gonna be putting moss anyway to allow the tarantula to make its web tunnels, because if you put just coconut fiber, it could collapse on the tarantula, the burrow, when it dries out. So moss right here, you see, super prepared once again, will allow the tarantula to sort of like allows it to hold its burrow. Yeah, shall we say that? There we go. Just this exact same enclosure as it was previously, the exact same setup. It's just that without freaking mold. Yeah, see? This moss is slightly damp. Sorry if you can hear like saw in the background, it's because they're building my new room. Yeah, if you haven't watched that video, links in the description below. The animal room is getting an upgrade, so feel free to go check out that video. I'll link it in the description below as well. It should be done in a month or two. Yep, super excited. Cannot wait till that one is done. We're gonna be doing like, okay, by the time this video is uploaded, you guys probably have seen the shoebox tarantula video. Yep, I put a lot of my tarantulas in shoeboxes recently because the weather here has been pretty dang hot every single day. My friend told me when I went to New Zealand, it did not rain. Like, I went for 2 weeks, not a single drop of rain. You guys know when I'm filming, every time it starts to rain, right? But when I leave for New Zealand was raining every single day when I was there. I think the rain like followed me, yeah. Thank you. But then over here, it was like not a single drop. Like, what the hell? Are you serious? Man, I've got to wash this. But yeah, no rain here, super hot. So that is why I put my tarantulas in shoeboxes to keep them on damp substrate. So it would like lower down the temperature. And when I came back, don't worry, even the dry species, they're doing super fine. If it was raining here and the weather was cool, I will not keep them on damp substrate. But I mean, yeah, I'm just doing everything that I can based on the environment over here. So don't judge. So yeah, this one over here, damp substrate as well, because the heat wave here is still going on. It's not fun at all. So yeah, I'm rambling too much. Let's go fill this cap up and we're good to go. Oh yeah, by the way, as I was saying, the new tarantula room, the one that we're currently under renovation, under currently building right now, it's gonna have like built-in cabinets as well as custom-made naturally, natural setup, like a desert setup for desert species and like tropical setup for tropical species. I'm asking my friend who does like bioactive setups to help me do tarantula enclosures because I kind of like suck at that. So he does a pretty good job. The whole tarantula room will pretty much be like a showroom, like a display room, which I think it's gonna be pretty darn cool. So the shoebox stuff, that's just temporary for the heat wave. Oh man, I just dirtied the whatever. So yeah, without any further ado, yeah, the details for the animal room, we will do that in another video. So hello, heart butt. So now, without any further ado, we're going to get this girl into her enclosure, which is gonna be a little bit difficult, a little bit more challenging if she does not cooperate. Oh, come on, walk slowly. No, you're not going that way, you're going into the cup. No, you're not going that way. Come on, man, you're not going that way. Hey, you see, they can't really bolt on this carpet, which is good. I think from now on, I'm gonna be doing rehousings on this carpet because it's pretty cool. Makes stuff pretty easy. Hey, where are you going? Oh my god, you're supposed to go down, girl. Go down. Okay, you know what? There we go, now we can see better. I just turned on my phone's flashlight. So let's go, girl, let's go. No, come on, cooperate, girl. There we go, yes, thank you. Oh no, oh my god, why do you do this to me? Seriously, girl, come on, you gotta like get down. You know what, I'll just close this because I don't want any more. Well, okay, you wanna fall, you can fall. So yeah, guys, check this out. Beautiful rehouse. Yeah, so that will be it for this video. It's not a video that I was very happy. I mean, I was pretty happy to make this video, but I wasn't very happy to come across mold because I rehoused her in this, like I mentioned, like 2-3 months ago, and it was like perfectly fine. And then when I go to New Zealand and I come back, and yeah. So that will be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to thumbs it up. If you didn't, feel free to thumbs it down. New to this channel, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care and peace. And the best part was no mess whatsoever. Wait, what? Nah, you know, I just cannot be neat for once. I will have to make some form of mess when I do a rehouse. So yeah, that's just me.